Hi everyone, welcome again to my YouTube channel Fitness Freak Computer Geek. In the last session of book review, we have discussed about the fourth lesson of Rich Dad and Poor Dad. Now continuing the lecture, let me now discuss about the fifth lesson, that is the rich invent money. So without wasting any time, let's begin. Robert began this story by sharing the experience of that he began teaching in the year 1984. So he shared that it is one of the beautiful profession to have, and also in the same time most disturbing one. Why say like that? Because you know, most of the people didn't want to get change in their life. They want to live in old-fashioned way, old-fashioned thinking. So that's Robert does not like this thing in people. According to him, we have tremendous potential and mind is our greatest gift, but we didn't use it. And one thing hold us back is because of lack of taking risks. Because of this, people lag behind. Although they have tremendous potential as well, they are mostly blessed with gift, but yet they are lagging behind it because of lack of confidence and degree of self-doubt. But most people just stuck on their academics, but in real world more than academics is required. So that factor which we require more than the grade will ultimately decide someone's future. As a teacher, he experienced that it is lack of self-doubt that made people lack people to achieve their success. So often in real world, it's not the smart that get ahead, it is the bold one. So according to Robert's own experience, your financial education required both technical knowledge as well as courage. If the fear is so much great, then genius you have, your genius mind will be suppressed. Most of you will be thinking that I am smart, I will do something else. But being smart is not the only thing. You have to be bold in your decision. Every time you have to take bold decision, otherwise you will lag behind the other people's. Most of the time, Robert heard that people always ask him why to take risks, why to develop my financial skill as I am working for my company and earning the wages. The most genuine answer and most reasonable answer Robert always give them is because to have more options. He believed that finding a way to earn million is far better than chasing a rise. This is the principle in which he is living since he was 9 years old. Now Robert discussed about that about 300 years ago, land was your greatest wealth. People who own more land are the rich one. And as the time changes in the last century, industries and factory own the wealth. The people who saw industrialists are rich at that time. But now today is information age. People with right timing information will be ahead of everyone and will be have earned more money and ultimately reach their zenith. So Robert finds so many people suffering today, working very hard because they cling into the old talk. They didn't want to get change in their life. They want to be think to be the way they were and resist any changes that hinder their growth. So in 1984 he began teaching, and so then he used the aid of gaming and simulation. He didn't like the traditional lecture. According to him, those lessons were bored and people didn't learn much from that lecture. So in that case, he launched a game called Cashflow. We can find this game in his website, Rich Dad and Poor Dad. So using this game, he taught people how to invest your money and how to become rich and how to coming out of rat race. These people are often creative and they take calculated risks. Why? Because their financial IQ is very strong. So most people think that rich people are luckier, they are lucky. But if you want to be luckier and create money instead of working hard, then you have to work on your financial IQ. This is the only thing which will make you more luckier, and you will invent your own money rather than working from some company to earn your money. And if you are a kind of person who is waiting for a right thing to happen, you might have to wait very longer. So single most greatest asset in this world is your mind. If it is trained well, then it can create an enormous wealth. An untrained mind can create extreme poverty that can crash the family for generation. So you can find a difference here. In information age, money is increasing exponentially. People with right time information become rich ridiculously. For example, Jeff Bezos, Mark Zuckerberg, you can take their example. Author shared it in this book. So poor work for money and rich invent their own money. That is the topic Robert want to discuss in today's lesson, in this lesson, fifth lesson of his book. Okay, he then starts to giving his personal experience of real estate, how we earn $20,000 by doing nothing, almost nothing. You can also do the same thing by using the four skills that he have discussed in the last lesson. Using the four skills, you can develop your financial IQ to such level you can learn the way of investing and become richer in very short interval of time. So always remember, an investor is who buy, not sell. So buying everything, like buying anything, like stock, building, rental house, anything, you can reach your vision. Robert didn't tell that he used example only as a numerical and chronological illustration, actual and simple case, and not to brag about himself. That point he want to be clear at this point. Personally, Robert said that he have two main vehicle to become rich. One is realistic and one is to buy stocks. And two tools Robert used enhance his financial skill to and become rich. So he didn't recommend anything that he didn't do. All the example, he only recommend those things in which he is successful. Okay, he didn't say anything, blindly support anything that he didn't believe, didn't he have tried it out. Opportunity is so small, if he didn't understand any investment, he didn't do it. So he gave an example of buying a house of 75,000. While he gave their example that while jogging around their home, he found a struggle man who want to move on to different country and desperately want to sell his own property, and that property worth was $75,000, but somehow he was so eager to sell it that he sell Robert to only $22,000 with a $2,000 down payment. Now again, after the house legally become his, he just write a banner that $75,000 is sell for $26,000, and immediately his house is sold. So you can see how instantly he make money of $20,000 without involvement any complex scenarios, just and also in a legal way. You can see that here. So he found that you have to grasp the opportunity. Opportunity is everywhere. You just have to be aware and keep alert your five senses so that you can grasp the opportunity at the main time, and you can take advantage of the opportunity. So point of this example is how small amount can grow into large amount. So again, it is understanding of financial, you know, statement, market, everything. Okay, so you must note that point. He didn't do it blindly. Okay, he just firstly understand the financial statement and the market, what's going on, then he do that. So remember this point also. So if your financial IQ is strong, then you will understand the deal, what about a deal, very easily, that it is a deal going to be catastrophic or it will be beneficial to you. So with the help of financial IQ, so it is your financial intelligence that spot develop your instinct to distinguish between a bad deal and a good deal. So you might say that it is gambling he is doing, you know, but it's not gambling. Gambling is what? Not gambling because you know what you're doing. It would have been a gambling if you just purchase something and just start prayer and do nothing, going on money and start praying. That would be the gambling. Of course there is risk, but more you have financial intelligence, more you are able to handle the risk. So one thing which might be a risk, lot riskier to one people, they might be a very low risk to another person. Why? Because of the difference of financial intelligence they have. More you develop your financial intelligence, more you will able to handle risks and lower the cases of risks, and you will earn more money. So that's why Robin advised people to invest more money on their finance rather than real estate and stock. If you develop your mind itself, then you will able to understand the investment, and then you will able to purchase anything you want and buy anything and sell for yourself and earn your money, and you don't have to depend on your day job for your pay only. Okay, and you can get your freedom, enjoy your freedom. There is no freedom in doing jobs, according to Robert, he wants to convey here. So he giving now example of two kind of investment. There are passive investor and there is active investor. Who are passive investor? Who just buy stock, who are stock broker, something like that, and real estate agent. They are, passive investor. And there was active investor, which he is talking about the investor who create their own investment. And this is the more professional one, that the risk that taught him to do as a 9-year-old kid. So he advised to be the second kind of investment, that is create your investment, assemble the everything in your investment. Okay, for example, you purchase a computer, assemble computer from different device and connect them. That's why the professional investor do. So now to become a second type of investor, you have to keep in mind in 3 points, and you have to work on these 3 points. So first one is find an opportunity which everyone else miss. So go around, do something. Always you be open to suggestion and you just look for opportunity which everyone else missing. Okay, take the example of Robert, how he gave to jog in his neighborhood and the neighbors want to sell his house. So you have to find the opportunity which most people miss. So second one is to raise money. So most people say that I will invest when I will have money, I will when bank will provide me a loan, but this does not occur. You have to find a way to earn money quickly and save it and use it for investment. There should not be any excuse that you don't have money so you can't invest. So third one is organize smart people. Always hire these people who are smarter than you. They will help you in an hour of need. When you need advice, they will advise you well. So always hire people smarter than you. So at last, there is always a risk, but learn to avoid the risks by using your financial intelligence. Okay, that's all for today. In the next lesson, we will discuss about the sixth lesson of Rich Dad and Poor Dad. Okay, So then for now, thank you. Thanks for watching. See you soon.